Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay. Today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on DSB, SSB, AM modulation and demodulation trainer, in which we are going to see the amplitude modulation with the single sideband modulation as well as with the double sideband modulation. Also we will see the demodulation of both the type of modulation circuits. AM or amplitude modulation is a simplest technique for modulation or to transmitting the signal from one place to another, in which we are using the message signal which is superimposed with a carrier signal of higher frequency, then the output is superimposed according to the amplitude of the message signal. Then this is can be easily rectified and carried out by demodulation circuits to verify the original signal which is sent from the transmitter section to the receiver end. By using some of the implementation in circuit for gain and amplitude, we can get the signals to up to some kilometers of distance with the cable communication, or we can send this to the through the wireless communication using antennas. The complete trainer board in this video we are going to see is divided in different parts so that students can be learned all the sections of amplitude modulation, whether it is for double sided modulation or it is for single sided modulation. Then for demodulation we all also distributed all parts of demodulation technique. With this a student can easily get to understand the demodulation of modulated AM wave also. So the complete circuit is divided in transmitter and receiver section. There are two kits over here you can see. The first one is 40517, which is the transmitter section. Then the other kit is 40518. This is the demodulation or the receiver section, we can also say. So we are going to first see the 40517, the modulation trainer kit. I will explain all the parts of this completely and then we see all the practical with this kit. So this is the main trainer kit for DSB, SSB, AM transmitter trainer, in which we will study the modulation technique of AM or amplitude modulation with the DSB signal and the SSB signal as well. The complete study board carried out for experiment on double sideband AM generation, study of trapezoidal pattern, study of sideband AM generation, single sideband AM generation. The trainer board has the 1 MHz crystal oscillator tuned circuit which is presented over here. Then we have the balanced modulator and bandpass filter circuit for tuned circuit of DSB mode. So this is the double balanced amplitude modulator circuit. Then we have bandpass filter for ceramic. In this there is another double balanced amplitude modulator circuit for two signals to be combinedly superimposed, and the bandpass filter is also provided for that as well. Then we have input audio amplifier. We can provide the audio signal from the mic, which is also provided in the accessories. The microphone can be connected with this jack over here, and we can provide the appropriate volume output to the signal for audio signals as well. Then we have the AF modulation, audio frequency modulation generator. Modulated signal can be generated from 300 Hz to 3.5 kHz with the amplitude of 0 to 5 VPP, so that we can generate the desired value or desired amplitude message signal to superimpose it with the carrier signal for RF. Then we have IC regulated power supplies of 5V, -12V and +12V, which is on board and can be easily tested and detected that the circuit supplies or regulator supplies are not working or not. Then we have some switch folds to create the fault conditions in the circuit to check out the different values and how the circuit set will create fault, and we can recognize and rectify the fault by using the fault switches as well. Then we have BFO tuned oscillator circuit for 455 kHz oscillator for tuning the output with any of the required signal. The output amplifier transmitter also provided with the gain of DSB about 1 MHz and SSB for 1.44 MHz. We can connect this with the cable, and also the antenna is also provided so that signals can be transmitted wirelessly from the antenna as well. Cable output can be also connected at this test point. There are a lot of completely about 10 test points. We can test all the waveforms at different test points as well. and there is some patch codes and manuals to study all the theories and all the practicals in detail to perform the experiments on the trainer board as well. And the microphone, as I explained earlier, also provided to giving the audio signal for modulation as well. So now we are going to see some of the experiments from the user manual on this trainer board to study the amplitude modulation. The transmitter trainer is provided to generate the modulation signal and transmit to this over the antenna, or we can use the cable for transmitting the section. Later on, we will also observe the demodulation part using the other trainer. So first, we will study the amplitude modulation with the transmitter trainer. So now we are going to do the study of various signals and various waveforms first, which are required to provide the message signal. Also, we will study the carrier waveform from the RF carrier signal oscillator from the variable range. First, we will connect the power supply on the trainer board with the 230 volt power supply AC source, and then power on this trainer board using this on-off switch. Then we will use a CRO to check the different waveforms. So I am connecting the probe on the CRO, or you can use the DSO as I am using. So our CRO and the cable has been connected. Now we will study the different signals of different waveforms. This is the ground point of the trainer board, and there are some more ground points. You can connect any of the ground point for any signals. First, we will study the AF modulation signal generator, in which we will see the audio frequency generation of a sine wave. So this is the output of the sine wave. The frequency and amplitude can be adjusted with the amplitude and frequency port. So this is the amplitude port. Right now we are getting the amplitude about 5 volts. So I am decreasing the amplitude, and we can see the same amplitude is also decreasing at the CRO screen. Now, to increase the frequency, right now frequency is about 2 kHz, which as the port is at the minimum medial position of this range. Now I am increasing the frequency, which is can be increased up to 3.4 kHz. So this is the maximum frequency from here, and at the minimum we can get the frequency from 300 kHz. So frequency is about 300 kHz. And can continuously increase up to 3.4 kHz from this frequency potentiometer. So this is the audio frequency generator. Now we will study the RF generator. For this, we will connect the ground probe on the ground terminal, and we will test the signal connecting with this to TP9. So right now we are getting the carrier frequency of about 470 kHz. Using this potentiometer, we can increase the carrier frequency up to 1 MHz. Let me auto-tune the TSU, and we will get the 0.4 MHz kilo frequency of carrier wave. Also, we can adjust the amplitude using the amplitude probe or amplitude knob. So we can get the maximum up to 10 VPP of the amplitude at 1 MHz. We can decrease the amplitude as well. So now I have connected the patch cord on the probe so that we can get the proper undistorted output. So right now the voltage is decreasing when I am decreasing the knob of the amplitude potentiometer. So we can get 0 from 10 VPP at the output. So this is our carrier signal. Now the basic modulation technique says we have to superimpose the carrier signal, and the message signal is generated from the AF modulation generator so that we can transmit this to the amplitude modulated wave. So there is circuit of double balance amplitude modulator. So we will provide modulating input at this point and the RF frequency and RF carrier at this point, and at the amplitude output waveform we will see the amplitude modulated output. So that's how all the circuitry works. Now we will follow the procedure as per given in the user manual to study the practical step by step. Now for amplitude modulation, we will first provide the audio signal using a patch code, the sine wave output, to the modulating input section of double balance modulator. Now we will provide the RF signal from the RF output at the RF carrier signal, and also the 1 volt power supply is also need to be connected to provide the proper gain of the modulated waveform. Now we will observe the output at the amplitude modulation waveform or output section. Now after doing these connections for the complete circuit, now we will connect the CRO probes. We will connect the channel 1 for the input signal, which is our audio frequency generation signal, and we will connect the modulated output signal, which is AM modulated from the double balance amplitude modulator, which will be connected on the channel 2, and we will observe both the channels on the same screen and study the working of amplitude modulation. So first we will connect the input signal on the channel 1. So this is our sine wave input signal. You can observe it on the CRO, which is giving the amplitude is about 1.21 and frequency is about 3.50. You can adjust the amplitude using the potentiometer. Now we will observe the modulated output at the modulation output section. For this we will connect ground of the double balance modulator signal circuit, and modulated output for taking it at the channel 2, we will connect this at the TP2. So here our modulated output is now on the screen. We can adjust the amplitude to get the proper output of the amplitude signal or the message signal. Here, as I am adjusting the signal, we can get the proper modulated output on the CRO screen as well. We can adjust the carrier frequency. If I am increasing the carrier frequency, at the higher frequency amplitude slightly decreases, and if I decrease the frequency, you can see the modulated output is slightly very visible on the CRO screen. So that's how we study the modulation of double sideband modulation. Now we will study the trapezoidal waveform of the output. So for this we do not need to add any connection, we just need to change the CRO measurement on the XY screen and we can observe the trapezoidal waveform also. Now to observe the trapezoidal pattern, we just need to adjust the CRO measurement on XY display. For this I am changing the format to XY display, and here we are getting the trapezoidal waveform after adjusting some volts per division. So that's how we are getting the trapezoidal output. At this time, if I increase or decrease the carrier or message signal, we can get the variation in that as well. Here right now I've decreased the carrier frequency very low. Also if I increase the carrier amplitude or decrease the carrier amplitude, we can get the output variation as well. And for message signal, if I increase the amplitude of message signal, our trapezoidal waveform is slightly increasing. So you can observe the various variation in the output with adjusting the amplitude frequency of carrier signal and as well as message signal. So that's how the trapezoidal pattern generates and giving the output. You can also study the modulation index with the trapezoidal pattern. If your output is have the waveform like this, then your modulation index is less than 1, and if you get the proper triangular trapezoidal pattern, almost like this, then your modulation index is near about 1 or is equals to 1, and if we are getting the waveforms like this, then the modulation index will be greater than 1. So if we adjust the amplitude, and here we get the complete triangular trapezoidal pattern. Now at this time, if we switch to again display in YT format, so we will get the proper modulated output like this, and slightly adjust the amplitude and we can get the proper trapezoidal pattern on the screen. So that's how you can study the modulation index and proper modulated output on the CRO using trapezoidal pattern. Now, in continuation with this practical, we will study the single sideband amplitude modulation. To achieve the single sideband amplitude modulation, we will utilize the following 3 blocks. Then we will use the amplitude module balance modulator, then we use ceramic bandpass filter and bandpass filter for block number 6. So these are the 3 basic blocks to achieve the output of single sideband balance modulator. So here we can see that the 2 input of the balance modulator is that the signal first is the audio frequency sine wave from the audio oscillator block, which is given to that modulation input point, and the other signal is the sine wave whose frequency is slightly less than 455 kHz. It is generated by the 455 kHz oscillator block. You can use this block for this as well, or you can generate the 455 kHz from the RF signal generator using the frequency knob provided on this. Now we will examine the output of balance modulator block together with the modulating signal trigger, the oscilloscope on the modulating signal, then check with the waveforms should be as per given in the user manual. Then balance modulator output is double sideband suppressed carrier DSBSC AM waveform, and it has been obtained by the amplitude modulating the carrier sine wave of frequency FC with the audio frequency modulating signal of the frequency FM, and then removing the carrier component from the resulting AM signal. Then we get the proper output of single sideband generation. So for carrier signal, we can provide the carrier from the BA4 455 kHz oscillator, or we can adjust the RF carrier signal up to 455 kHz, because the ceramic bandpass filter has the passing range for 455 output. So we can note that the bandpass filter has a narrow bandpass centered around 455 kHz, And it was mentioned earlier that the frequency of the carrier input to the balanced modulator block has been arranged to be slightly less than 455 kHz. In fact, the carrier is chosen so that whatever the modulating frequency FM, the upper sideband at the FC plus FM will be fall inside the filter's pass band, when the lower sideband will be always falls outside the false band. Consequently, the upper sideband will suffer the little attenuation, while the lower sideband will be heavily attenuated to such an extent that it can be ignored. So we will see the attenuation in the lower sideband and observe the single sideband generation of amplitude modulation. So first we will connect the CRO probe to the RF generator, as we are going to use the RF for the amplitude modulation and carrier signal. Here we are getting the frequency is about 442 kHz. So we will increase this and adjust this about 450 kHz. This is now 450 kHz and amplitude is about 5 volts VPP. So this is now 5 volts VPP. You can adjust the value of both the amplitude and frequency of the carrier signal, which is about 450 kilohertz around, and amplitude is about 5 volts. So this is our carrier signal for this time, because we are going to use the ceramic bandpass filter. Now we will move on to the trainer board again. And at this time, the input from the RF generator, make sure you do not move the knob for this experiment, or you can use the BF oscillator as well. Now RF will be connected to the RF carrier again, and amplitude modulated output will be connected to the input of ceramic band pass filter. So this is our ceramic band pass filter. Now we will observe the output at the output terminal of ceramic band pass filter. Now adjust the CRO. We will also observe the input signal or message signal at the channel 1. So this is our sine wave at the channel 1, which is our message or input signal, and the amplitude modulated waveform of single sideband is showing on CRO screen right now. Here we can observe the upper sideband is slightly attenuated from the lower sideband, and which is heavily attenuated. If we adjust the bandpass filter knob, we can get the variation in the output waveform as well. So here, after adjusting slight tuning in the carrier frequency, we can observe that the lower sideband is slightly more attenuated than the upper sideband on the CRO screen. If increase the amplitude and position of the signal, you can observe the difference clearly. So that's how the ceramic bandpass filter behaves for generating the single sideband amplitude modulation. So that was the single sideband generation from ceramic bandpass filter. There is another bandpass filter of the regular components. We will also use this bandpass filter as well. For this, just need to connect the input of the modulated output waveform to the input of bandpass filter and observe the output from the output terminal of the bandpass filter as well. Here you can see the gain is slightly lower. If we adjust the frequency slightly of the carrier, so we can get the proper output at 455 kilohertz. We just need to tune the proper frequency to get the proper output. Here you can see the gain is slightly more decreased due to we are getting the proper modulated output from the bandpass filter. You can observe the output closely on the CRO screen. Here, this is the output from the bandpass filter. You can also use the BFO 455 kHz oscillator to get the proper output. Now, if I turn the frequency or change the frequency from the RF generator, the output is slightly decreased and continuously not passing because this has the range of 455 kHz for passing. And as I reach the 455 kHz, again I will get the proper modulated output from the bandpass filter to be filtered. Here you can see if I increase the output continuously from the frequency port of RF generator, the output will be decreasing. So there is a specific band in which the output is completely visible. So just need to tune the maximum output gain and we can get the proper output from bandpass filter, which is the single sideband output. Now we are going to study the operation of automatic gain controller circuit or the output amplifier circuit for this section. As the output is generated, AM signal is generated and modulated and generated, this need to be amplified to be transmitted over the cloud or over the transmitting section. We can use the transmitting from the cable or as well as the antenna. Both the features are provided on the trainer board. The antenna is a telescopic type of antenna, can be increased for transmitting the signal properly, and there is a switch to transmit the signal over cable or antenna which can be selectable. Then we have the on-off switch for the output of single sideband to be generated. There is a switch for selecting the single sideband and double sideband as well as. So you can select any of the signal to be transmit or whichever as the double sideband or as the single sideband generation. So this is all working of the output amplifier. There is a volume controller knob or the gain controller knob so that the output gain of the modulated output which going to transmit is can be also adjusted from this. So first we will study the transmission of double sideband modulator or double sideband modulated output. For this, we have already connected the input signal from the audio frequency generator. RF generator is also connected to the double balance modulator. You can use this double balance modulator as well as this double balance modulator, both work as the same. Now we will give the output or modulated output to the automatic gain controller circuit output amplifier, and right now we have to select the switch to the DSB because we are going to provide the DSB. When the signal is provided from any of the bandpass filter, then we will select the switch to the SSB mode. Now we will observe the input signal on the channel 1 For this, ground is already connected. Now I'm going to connect the CRO probe for getting the signal output of the sine wave, which is about 1.5 in amplitude and 2.2 kilohertz. So we'll make this 2 kilohertz using the frequency potentiometer. So we have matched the frequency 2 kilohertz and amplitude is about 1.5. So we have adjusted both the values. Now we will see the automatically gain control output on the output terminal of TP8. For cable, we will select the switch to the cable signal and check the output. First, we will see the amplitude modulated output is right now having the amplitude about 2.5. Now, if I check the output on the cable and turn on the switch, increase the potentiometer's output gain, so we can get the output amplified up to 3.7. right now it's continuously increasing, so need to adjust the CRO. Here we are getting the gain up to 3.8, 4, 4.5, 5 volts. Till the output is distorted, we can increase the gain. Here now output is distorting slightly. So here this is the maximum gain, which is about 6 volts. Our input of the signal is about 2 volts or about 1.5 volts. And the modulated output has a gain of about 6 volts for this. You can see all the study closely here. This is the amplitude output from the output amplifier. If I am decreasing the gain, we can get the proper output, which is 4.6 volt. And if I increase the gain till the output waveform distorted here, now the output waveform is clipping, so we will decrease the output to get the proper waveform of the amplitude modulated waveform. So we can adjust and consider that the 6 or 5.5 volts will be sufficient for the amplitude for this. Here you can see on the channel 1, the amplitude signal is about 1.5 volt and the modulated waveform has the gain of about 5.6 volt, which is also required to increase the gain for transmitting the signal, because there will be some losses in the signal when we recover the signal at the output end. Now similarly, the same output can also be observed on the antenna terminal for wireless communication as well. For this, just turn this knob to the antenna section and here you can see the output is completely wiped out from the screen. Now if I move this cable from the TP8 and connect this to the antenna terminal, we can get the signal again. Here you can see the signal is transmitting from the antenna. Ground is already connected to the kit, so this is the signal from the antenna which is transmitting. So that's how you can observe the output from the antenna or the output amplifier as well. Now to observe the single sideband output, we just need to provide the signal from the bandpass filter, any of the bandpass filter, whether it is ceramic or normal bandpass filter, we can use and get the single sideband output. Now similarly, to observe the single sideband output, we will do the simpler procedure as we provide the output from the amplitude modulated using the bandpass filter. So we will first provide the output of amplitude modulation or AM output to the bandpass filter, and the output of bandpass filter will be going to the audio amplifier. Just need to on the circuit for the single sideband and turn the knob to the single sideband modulation And now we will auto-tune the CRO to get the modulated output of single sideband. Here you can see we are getting the output modulated on the single sideband. Make sure the carrier frequency is about 450 kilohertz or near about the 450 kilohertz to get the proper output. Now if I adjust the frequency, you can see the output has the variation because the ceramic bandpass filter or the bandpass filter both have the frequency of bandpass about 455 and near about the 455 kilohertz. So that's how the single sideband can also be transmitted through the amplifier section. Now we will observe the amplitude also. So we can increase the amplitude. Using the proper attenuated output. Here we are getting about 500 millivolts as the single sideband output, or 500 to 600 millivolts as the maximum. Similarly, the output can also be transmitted over antenna. Just need to turn the switch to cable from antenna and we can get the output on the antenna as well. So that's how we have performed the amplitude modulation. We have generated the amplitude modulated wave using the transmitter section and using the transmitter from output amplifier, and amplified output can also be transmitted from that antenna as well as the cable transmission. We will also observe the audio input. For this we will use a mic and the microphone to giving the audio input amplifier signal instead of frequency generated audio signal, audio frequency generated of sine wave. We will use the mic to giving the audio signal from the audio generator audio input amplifier section, and we will see observed output on the transmitter section as well. Now to implementing the input audio amplifier block, we will just need to connect the signal which are modulated input signal which is connected to balance modulator from the sine wave. Remove this input from the sine wave and connect this from the audio amplifier's output, input audio amplifier's output, and we will connect the microphone provided from the accessories on the jack provided on the front screen. Make sure to on the switch in the on position, and volume can be adjusted with the volume port provided on this screen. Now the signal is modulating. We have provided the carrier signal to the wireless modulator as well. Now we will observe the signals on the output of the output amplifier. Now if I am speaking something in the mic, here you can see the waveforms is distorting and the output is amplified according to my voice on the CRO screen. We will also observe the input signal on the CRO using the channel 1 probe. Here you can see the input is distorting as I am speaking in the mic, and waveform is also modulating according to the speech from the mic. So this is how the voice is modulated from the microphone, and we can get the output on the amplifier as well. The output can be amplified properly using the voice and the volume buttons on both the side of input audio amplifier and output audio amplifiers section. You can guess the closed loop on the CRO. Now as I am speaking, there is some distortion in the waveforms continuously. So that's how we transmit the voice signal also from the transmitter. Now to see the demodulation output for all the signals, we will study and observe the output on the demodulator kit, which is 40518. So this is over here is the DSB, SSB, SC, AM receiver trainer, the order code 40518. In this, there are a lot of demodulation technique circuits are provided. We'll study all the demodulation circuit after amplitude modulation has been transmitted. Also, there is an RF amplifier and a receiver with the antenna and cable as well. We are sending the signals through antenna and cable. So we can receive the signals through antenna or through the cable providing with the RF amplifier. After that signal is received, then the signal is amplified through this RF amplifier circuit block. Then we have the first RF mixer or IF transmitter 2. So this is the mixer or IFT in which we will mix the signal with the local oscillations, because the local oscillation and local oscillator is also required to match the amplitude modulated signals to verify and carry out the signal or the message signal from the amplitude modulated waves. For this, the signal need to be mixed with the local oscillator and the RF input from the antenna and or even from the cable. Then it is fed to the first IF amplifier, at where the signal has been amplified through some values. Then we have the second IF amplifier, at which the signal is continuously amplified and we get the proper gain output, modulated output as well. After that, there is envelope detector or product detector is provided to find out and recover the single sideband signals. Upper side is provided for double sideband signals. Then we have local oscillator, which can generate the frequency about 455 kHz and has the providing tuning for 980 kHz to 650 kHz with the tuning knob. Then envelope detector, as I explained, we can generate both type of signals with this, and we can create and see the phase angle difference with the plus minus switch over here, so that we can see the signal in the negative and positive side both. Then we have the IC regulated power supplies for complete working of the circuit, in which we have plus 5 volt, minus 12 volt and plus 12 volt power supply, so that the circuit is continuously working and we can check the supply on the front panel of the kit. Then we have BFO local oscillator or crystal oscillator for 455 kHz. This is required for tuning circuits. Then we have output audio amplifier. The output, which is amplified and demodulated from the various circuitry provided on the front panel, will be outputly can be generated, and if amplified output can be output given from this output audio amplifier. There is also terminals to connect the miniature speaker for that. We can connect up to 8 ohm speaker from this signal amplifier, and we will observe the voice signal and other signals from the output amplifier circuit as well. There is also a volume control knob to increase and decrease the output audio from this knob, and the complete circuitry works on the 230 volt AC power supplies. And we have the switch faults of 8 knobs. The switch faults can be provided for different various functions. All the details are given in the user manuals, and there are 14 test points on the complete trainer board, so we can test the waveforms and outputs on the different 14 places. So the main object of this complete receiver trainer is to study the DSB, SSB, SC, AM reception and detection by the diode and the product detectors. We will study the AGC circuit, automatic gain controller circuit, for this as well. Then we study the tune circuits from the tuning circuitry, and then we study the sensitivity, selectivity and fidelity of the receiver. User manual, in which all the details about the practicals and information and study, detailed theoretical study also provided in the user manual for the demodulation of AM generated waves, and patch codes are also provided in the accessories, so that you can easily match up all the connections to find out your demodulated waveforms through this receiver unit. So this was the complete circuit description of this kit. Now we move on to the complete working, and we will find out the demodulation waveforms. For this, we also required the modulator circuit kit. So we will study both the experiment with combinedly joining the key, both the kits. Now we have adjusted both the trainer boards at adjacent distance and a distance about 3 to 5 inches. This is a distance to recover the and cover the both frames in a single frame, both the kits in a single frame. You can increase the distance for about up to 4 to 5 feet for the receiving and transmitting of signals. Now we will study the first practical of this trainer board, in which we will study of double sideband AM reception using envelope detector via cable. The circuit diagram and the connections are given in this user manual. These are for the receiving unit 40518, and the rest of the connections for the amplitude modulation generation are also described in the procedure, but you have to do it as per the amplitude generation 40517 practical and video, as I explained video earlier. So now we are going to first do the connections for amplitude modulation, then we do the connection as given in this user manual, and then we see the detected output or the demodulated output on the CRO. So firstly, as given in the user manual, we will do the connections for 40517, in which we will connect the output of AF signal generator in section 40517 sign output terminal socket to the input of balance modulator in the block number 2. That we have done in the video earlier as well. So we'll connect the sign output to the modulator input block. Similarly, we'll connect the RF output to the RF carrier input block. Then we have to connect the power supply and in the proper connectivity, and we have to set the signals to the desired value, in which the sine wave should be selected to 2 VPP and the frequency of this will be 1 kHz, and RF carrier will be set to 2 VPP and the frequency should be about 455 kHz. So we can set both the things using the CRO. Now we are going to adjust the sine wave first, which is the message signal or input signal to the circuit. Now we'll turn on the trainer board. Here we can measure the output and amplitude and frequency. So we'll increase the amplitude about 2 VPP as suggested in this manual, and frequency should also be near about 2 kHz, so which is 2 kHz also observed in the DSO. Now we will observe the RF signal. This should be about 2 VPP and 455 kHz. So we'll observe the RF as well. Frequency need to be set about 455 kHz. So this is near about 450. Almost 455 kHz, and amplitude also need to be adjust about 2 VPP. So this is about 2 VPP now. So RF has been set, audio frequency has been set. Now we will see the modulated output at the output terminal as well of the double balance modulator circuit. So this is the modulated output here that we are getting in proper way. Now this output need to be fed to the DSB SSB SM receiver at the receiver unit. The output directly fed to the output amplifier, and from amplifier we will connect a cable to the receiver trainer and then we see the other circuits to demodulate the original message signal which is sent from the audio frequency generator from the transmitter unit. Now we are going to do the connection as given in the user manual of 40518. Same connections need to be done. For this, we first connect the RF output terminal with the RF input terminal on the mixer. Then we connect local oscillator output to the input of local oscillator. Now you will connect the output of mixer to the IF in circuit of first amplifier. Then we connect the IF1 output to with the IF input 2. Similarly, IF1 output to IF1 input. We'll also connect the AGC terminal with the AGC1 to the AGC input 2. Now output from the second amplifier will be connected at the input terminal of envelope detector. And at this point of the detector output, we will observe the output on CRO. Now, to transmit the output from antenna or cable, we just need to connect the A-modulated output of 40517 or the transmitter trainer to the input of output amplifier. Now, make sure while working with the cable, the switch should be at the cable mode. And this cable will be connected with the input terminal of RF. This one is for antenna and cable need to be connected over here. So now we will observe the output on the demodulated product detector. So to observe the output at the envelope detector section, we just need to connect the channel 2 on the envelope detector section. Here, right now you can see the output is not proper. So we need to provide some tuning by tuning all the knobs provided for amplitude and gain adjustment. Here, first need to increase the gain from the second IF amplifier. There are switch provided to adjust the gain also. Then we need to adjust the RF input terminal or input knob. And similarly, we need to adjust the amplitude of carrier from the modulating section as well. Carefully and slowly adjust the carrier. Also, you can adjust the output amplifier gain. You need to take some patience to adjust all the tunings properly and then you will get the proper demodulated output at the envelope detector section. So after tuning up the complete all the adjustment of gains and the other things, We can get the appropriate sine wave output of same values and same frequency. There is slightly amplitude difference, but it will be acceptable on this trainer board. Now we will also see the same product detector output with the audio signal voice transmission as well. So in the voice transmission practical, which is experiment number 6, we just need not need to change any of the connections. The connections need to be same, just need to extend the envelope detector output. This need to be connected to the output amplifier. At here we can connect any of the speaker and get the voice transmitted output. We will first see the sine wave output on the speaker, and then we connect the mic on the trainer board, and then we see the voice modulated output through the speaker. So this is the miniature speaker that we have now set down here, and we have to remove the patch cord or the oscilloscope test probe, and the output of product detector should be connected to input of output audio amplifier. We can adjust the volume with this volume knob, and now we will connect the speaker, the ground and positive to out. So that's how the speaker output is going on. So we can adjust the volume with the volume knob over here. If your output gain is slightly larger than the adjustment volume, you just need to decrease the output of the amplifier section from the transmitter section. Here, if I increase the amplifier output, the output slightly distorted. So we need to adjust the amplifier's output as well, and then we can adjust the volume of this. So at the output, we can also observe that the output is amplified sine wave. So slight ground issues through the CRO is occurred. That's why we cannot observe the waveform on the CRO right now. But this is the sine wave output that we are getting on the product detector after amplifying through the audio amplifier. Now for voice signal, we just need to change the sine input from the audio amplifier's output and connect this to the audio input from the input audio amplifier circuit. And here we need to connect the mic with the jack, and as I am speaking, the output on the CRO from the audio input amplifier is continuously varying, and similarly we can observe the output on the speaker as well. Here you can see the output from the speaker can also be hearable, and you can adjust the gain of both the sides to get the proper output on this. So that's how voice transmission has been done through the AM modulation. Now we can also do the transmission through the antenna instead of cable. The antenna on both the trainer, transmitter and receiver are also provided. So we will transmit the signal through the antenna communication. For this, we just need to remove the cable. Now connection and link between both the transmitter and trainer has been bragged. Now we will turn the switch to antenna in both the section and completely expand the antenna on both the trainer boards. And slightly need to adjust the gain so that we can get the similar output through antenna as well. Here, now we are getting the output. As the transmission is wireless, there might be some distortions, but that can be acceptable because this is a trainer kit. Still, we try to adjust the complete output for the education purpose and for get the proper communication. So this is almost sine wave of the same amplitude or frequency that we are getting from antenna communication. Similarly, we can also transmit the voice. Now for voice transmission, at the input side, we just need to change the input to audio amplifier and need to connect the microphone on the jack. And at output side, we just need to connect the speaker. First, we need to connect the output of amplifier envelope detector to the output amplifier, audio output amplifier, and then we will connect the speaker on both the terminals of this audio output amplifier. So we are getting now some distortions, which is due to the antenna transmission. But if we adjust the gain and some proper tuning, after that we can get the proper voice communication output on the receiver side. At this section, we can adjust the volume as well. The output might have slightly distorted, it cannot be properly clear, but here you can see the output is transmitted through the wireless communication properly. So that's how we perform the demodulation output of the audio signal as well through the microphone, and we have got the demodulated output on the speaker. Now for the study of sensitivity, in this practical we just need to adjust, no need to change any of the connection. And the last practical, we just need to adjust the local oscillator frequency about 1050 kHz, and RF carrier input should be about 455 kHz that we have already set. Now we just need to connect all the connections as given in the user manual. After that, we just need to adjust the RF input by varying the output of 1 amp potentiometer in such a way that we should get the minimum output. So we'll adjust this potentiometer to get the minimum output. Through the RF input terminal, let us say this is our minimum output or visible output where we are getting the output detected output. Here at this time we will observe the carrier frequency on the transmitter, and then at this time we will also observe the local oscillator frequency in kilohertz, and the detected output is about 1.6 volt, so we can mention this about in millivolt and fill up the table in this observation table given in this user manual, and you can plot the graph of output detector in output on y axis and local oscillator frequency in x axis. So at this time you can adjust and take out the selectivity of this transmitter and receiver unit. Similarly, you can find out the selectivity and fidelity also in this manner. Now for the sensitivity and the selectivity of the receiver cable, the last one for the sensitivity. Now we will observe the selectivity of the transmitted signal. For this, the same connections need to be done. We just need to increase the carrier frequency in terms of 10 kHz At different carrier frequency, we have to observe the ambilight detector output in millivolts, record the readings in this observation table, and then plot the graph. You will get the similar graph like this for the selectivity of your transmitter and receiver section for your modulation. Now in the next practical, we are going to see the study of single sideband AM reception using product detector. In this, the connection diagram is given in the user manual. The transmitter section diagram remains the same. We will just need to generate the modulated output from the transmitter signal, and after that we will demodulate the output through the product detector, in which we just need to adjust the modulated output to the SSB setting. For this, we also need to adjust some changes in the transmitter section as well, because we are now doing the single sideband product detector practical. For this, RF need to be adjusted about 455 kHz. So we will first adjust the RF. So we will auto-tune the CRO and adjust the RF frequency near about 455 kHz, which is almost set to 455 kHz. And amplitude is also need to be set about 2 VBP. So we will increase the amplitude. Near about 2 VPP. So that's how we set the RF signal. Similarly, we have to set the audio frequency generator signal. VPP need to be 2 and frequency need to be 3 kHz as suggested in this user manual. After that, we will adjust the signal frequencies according to the tuning of the demodulation output. So we'll increase the frequency about 3 kHz. Carefully increase the frequency. So this is now about 3 kHz, and VPP need to be set about 2 volts. Now we have to adjust the connections for single sideband. So the amplitude modulated output will be passing through the bandpass filter, and output of bandpass filter will connect it to input of output amplifier. So these changes had need to be made, and output need to be turned on and the switch to be SSB, so that we are working on the SSB modulation output. Now we have to make the connections as per the circuit diagram given in the user manual for the receiver section. Now we will connect the cable output directly to the mixer section at the RF endpoint through the transmitter, and now we have to connect the output of mixer to the IF in of the first amplifier. Then we need to connect the IF out 2 and IF out 1 to the IF in 2 and IF in 1 of second amplifier, and output from second amplifier will directly provided to the input on the product detector. For the carrier of the product detector, we just need to connect the output of local oscillator BFO 455 kHz oscillator, and output of crystal oscillator will be connected to the RF input or as a carrier input for product detector. Also, we need to connect the local oscillator with the tuned frequency to tuning the output at the input of local oscillator at the mixer section. Now the connection has been done. Now we can check the output detected on the pro-detector output demodulator section. For this we just need to connect the CRO on this terminal, and here we can get the sine wave output similar to the input from the transmitter section. So that's how we use the pro-detector in this. I have already spent a lot of time, about 10 to 20 minutes, to adjust the tuning of pro-detector output. You just need to adjust the frequency of the transmitter and amplitude also of the transmitter to adjust the proper sine wave output to tune with this pro-detector output. Here you can see if I change the frequency, the output is distorted, and if I change the frequency again slightly to match up this, we can get the proper tuned output at a 455 frequency or wherever the both frequency of pro-detector and the transmitter carrier signal matches. Also you need to adjust the amplitude to get the proper sine wave output, and you also can adjust the output amplifier gain knob to get the proper output on the receiver. So that's how we perform the experiment on DSB and SSB amplitude modulation and demodulation trainer kit. I have explained both the trainer kits in this video, and I also explained the all experiments, how to do perform the modulation and demodulation section with both the transmitter and receiver unit. Hope you get the proper information on how to do the experiments on this trainer kit, and still you find difficulty while working with this kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of support. And if you like this video, you please press the like button, and also you can share this video to your classmates, colleagues and your fellows to get the information about the amplitude modulation and demodulation at the practical purpose. You can also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube, to get the informative videos with the practical experience on that. There are a lot of videos with this type of educational trainer are uploaded. You can get the proper information with the highly qualified explanation provided on this channel as well. Also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload a new video, you can get the information about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.